Okay, it's another brand new edition of your favorite current affairs program, 60 Minutes Nigeria. My name is Ego Sagbolao. On today's edition of the program, we'll be looking at security threat and, of course, is the effect on the growth or the development of democracy in Nigeria. Some persons believe that, yes, democracy is still evolving in the country, while others believe that with the number of years that democracy has been in Nigeria, we ought to have gotten it right. Okay, so I have very distinguished personalities with me today. I have Ambassador Osasu Usembo, a very seasoned analyst. Nice to have you with us today. I also have with us a highly respected clergyman, Apostle Kesi Chukwu. Nice to have you with us today.
Thank you, everybody.
Okay. Well, I must say that when you look at the recent democratic trends, for instance, the Anambra election, where a former CBN governor, Professor Soludo, emerged governor of Anambra State, some persons believe that maybe Nigeria is getting it right. But the case surely is in court. That's another discussion for another day. But looking at the peaceful conduct of the election, after the sit-at-home threat by IPOB, eventually that threat was withdrawn, and the Anambra people voted for the candidate of the choice. If you look at other forthcoming elections, is Nigeria getting it right? But there is a monster. The monster is the security threat. Even before the Anambra election, the security threat was alarming. The destruction, killings, threats, it was really, really disturbing, and it gives cause for concern. As we speak, we've had other security threats around the country, and we are glad that the Nigerian military is actually, you know, helping to provide internal security, which ought not to be their primary focus, but they are doing it to assist the other sisters, security agencies. Okay, so we're going to start with Ambassador Osasu Usembo. You are an ambassador of peace. Yes. So, yes, looking at security challenges, do you think is really having effect on the development of democracy in Nigeria?
Well, I want to thank you very much for choosing this topic.
Yes.
This topic is quite apt, and at the same time, I think security has a broader sense. It's the same phenomenon all over the world.
Yes.
Security is security.
Okay.
Insecurity is insecurity.
Yes.
Well, as it borders on Nigeria situation.
Yes.
I want to say that first of all, I must thank the Nigerian military.
Okay.
Their level of gallantry.
Yes.
If not because of Nigerian military who have been there to prevent the advancement of insurgency and banditry in Nigeria, we don't know where we would have been by now.
Mm.
I also want to thank the Nigerian police for their resilience, because they are the one policing the internal security network of the nation. I want to thank them so much, particularly at those states. Commissioner Philip Badu and the DC Miller, who is Director of Operations. What they are doing a fantastic job in Edo State. I want to say that, like I said, security is not a recent phenomenon.
Okay.
Nigeria, as it were, we have experienced security and insecurity.
Okay.
But right now we are talking about insecurity in Nigerian nation.
Yes.
That is a state of anxiety, a state of doubt, a state of fear, a state whereby you don't have fear of faithlessness. So it's a pity that we have come to realize that insecurity in Nigeria has taken enough time to come, and it has affected us socially, psychologically, and otherwise. And therefore, it needs a concerted effort to be able to stop this issue of insecurity. And we all must come together. We must support the Nigerian military. We must support the Nigerian police and other sisters, security agencies. We ourselves must be our neighbor's keeper. The only way we can solve insecurity is to always live for the sake of others. We must not live for our sake. No. We must live for the sake of others. We must be our neighbor's keeper. When we become our neighbor's keeper, we go a long way to curb insecurity in Nigeria. Because right now, when something is happening in Borno, we say, oh, we are in Edo State, it's not our concern. When something is happening in Lagos, we say, no, it's not our concern. So it's acquirable. No, we are all Nigerians. As Nigerians, we never told God that we must hail from Nigeria. But we found ourselves that we are Nigerians. And automatically, with such concerted effort, with such cooperation, with some understanding, we must be able to curb this. It's people that perpetuate it. It's individuals that perpetuate it. We must continue to sing the song of security, a song of love, a song of peace. Because when we fail to sing the song of peace, there is no security. After all, when there is security, there is peace. It's only when we love ourselves, when we live for the sake of others, when I live for your sake, live for my sake, there is security. We'll be our neighbor's keeper. In Nigeria today, ethnicity have also, you know, creep into it, into the aspect of insecurity. And of course, when we don't have confidence on ourselves, because I am from this tribe, you are from the other tribe, you are not confident of yourself. And also, ethnic dominance it also goes a long way to straighten the issue of insecurity. So at this point, we all are Nigerians. We must see ourselves as one. We must see ourselves that this is our nation, Nigeria. And the only way we can be able to lift the national integrity, or rather patriotism, is for us to love ourselves. Okay. It's only love that can heal us, not righteousness, irrespective of your religion as well. This time around, God wants to teach us love, not righteousness. When we love ourselves, we can heal this country. Thank you very much.
Okay, we'll come back to you. Apostle Casey Chukwu, looking at insecurity, especially what transpired in the Anambra election, is a recent election we've had now. Do you think security challenges seem to be affecting the development of democracy?
Well, thank you very much.
Okay.
I want to say this concerning the Anambra election.
Yes.
I knew very well it was going to be peaceful election.
How?
Yeah, because what was happening, the killings was from residents of Anambra, even though they said they were from outside Anambra State. Now, the reason why I say so is because anything that government have hand cannot end like that. If it was, can't you see in Boko Haram, some state, Borno State, they have not been able to tackle security there because government have hand in insecurity. Now this Anambra State, because government does not have hand, they can come out at any time and tell you stop if you do anyhow, you see anyhow.
Okay.
So what we are having in Nigeria,
but I was also interject to say government does not have hand in insecurity. Government is fighting security, so they can't have hand in it.
The reason why I'm saying this is because if you watch, the AIG said that no police have the right to search your phone without a search warrant. And today, are we not seeing policemen? We have more than four videos that is going viral. Policemen beating people, searching their phone. And up till now, those people have not been brought to book. Nothing has been done. And they are still proud doing it. Now, if it was just an ordinary man, don't you think by now the person will be in cell or kiri-kiri? So what happened in Anambra election is not a surprising thing to me, because I know that if the Nigerian government want to bring peace and security to Nigeria, it will not take them one day to do it. It will not, because they know the look and crony of the area. When there was an insecurity in Edo State, what did the governor do? The governor came out and appointed vigilante. Today, I can proudly tell you that you can drive in the city of Benin
2 a.m., 3 a.m., safe, you will not see any cockroach or any threat on the road. Why? Because the government came out to say, no, we will not allow insecurity in Edo State. Now, in Anambra State, yes, the federal government came out and said, we will not allow insecurity in Anambra State. Anybody that will be caught will face it. Why can't such law be passed in what is happening in Benue, Kaduna, Katsina, all those states where they are killing people? We need such efforts by our government. If they really claim that, yes, we don't have hand in what is happening in this state, we don't know one, we don't know two, they should tackle it the way they tackle Anambra State. Or did they do it because Anambra is not in power, or the presidency is not from Anambra or from the east, so we can go there and oppress everybody? The way they treated the insecurity in Anambra State should be treated in every state. No one should go free in every state. Apart from Benin City, I don't think any other state is secure in Nigeria. And the federal government can do something about it. They should not pretend they don't know what is happening. It does not take them anything to clear insecurity. That's my view for that.
That's a great one. I think the point Apostle Kesi Chukwu has just made is that the effort of the federal government was really, really applauded in Anambra State. Yeah. The massive deployment of security personnel to Anambra State, I think that's the point he's making, that that kind of effort should be replicated in all other states of the Federation. But I think the federal government is doing a lot to actually tackle insecurity. But we'll just take a break now to enable us to introduce our third guest on the program, 60 Minutes Nigeria. Nice to know that you are there enjoying your 60 minutes with us on the program, 60 Minutes Nigeria. Just joining us is our youth leader in Edo State, our chairman of the Palm Produce Farmers Association, and of course, an analyst, Efosa Atoy. Nice to have you with us today. Yeah, we are looking at the security challenges. We are looking at security challenges and, of course, the effect on the development of democracy. And my guests have posited that yes, security challenges definitely has negative effects on not only on democracy but on the country. And one of my guests said, well, what happened in Anambra is something that we should learn from, that if the federal government could ensure security during the Anambra governorship election, it means security can be ensured in all other states of the country because it demands concerted efforts, just the way it was said in Anambra. So what's your take on this, your opening remarks?
On the issue of Anambra, that was a good one. We cannot use that to assess the security improvement in this country. We know the criminal element in every society, in every state, are always minus zero. And they make hell of noise. And the security operative, with the numbers of security personnel that was deployed to Anambra, we know there will not be a fly. And for the Nigerian government to concentrate on Anambra when we have 36 states, I believe what I know has worked for this country is not the personnel that was deployed there, it's the awareness. Money backed does not make victory. What is security now is who is the bailout, not the party. And
you cannot compare a former CBN governor running with other candidates. Like my party presented a candidate who was in PDP and APC is a candidate. PDP brought somebody. And Abga went and said, she brought somebody who with her party is marketable, with the party is marketable. So at the end of it all, we were thinking the hype up and whatever, this they are declaring of a Monday, no work, we hinder it. We now discover those are all games. And with the Anambra election now, the new governor-elect, which I believe is frowning, he did the analysis. He said Anambra is losing about 10 billion every Monday when they declare sit at home. So you will know such a governor will put a stop to such a menace. And if the people now said, we want you, so they are tired of this IPO declaring sit at home. So if that is what he believed in, and he came out, he was also a victim. The way they invaded his place, they smuggled him out. So for him to win, you will see that the people of Anambra are not criminals. They believe in this country and they believe in the unity of Nigeria. So for election to be held in Anambra, let the security agencies not take glory. It's the awareness, because I will tell you, the Anambra people are one of the enlightened people in the East. So for them to look, this party PDP, this party APC, this party HAPGA, they went for the lesser devil. That is what I will use. And HAPGA took the day. It's just the same thing in Edo. In Edo election, they will say PDP, APC. I said it one time. I said, they just changed their uniform. 2016, we know where this one was and where the other one was. And 2020, they changed their uniform. But Edo people did not vote party. Edo people voted person. And some of us are seeing the dividends, the security, whatever. To me, my remark is this. Security is not the personnel you recruit. It's information you let go. Who are there, who is there, who is the next neighbor. And once that is done, there will be improvement, there will be a security balance.
Thank you very much, Osasu. Well, Ambassador, moving forward, Ambassador Osasu Usembo is an ambassador of peace, so he's always promoting peace wherever he goes. Now, moving forward, yes, how do you think the federal government can really get it right in terms of ensuring security of lives and property? The Chief of Defense Staff was in Edo State 2 days ago, and is actually toying military formations to boost the morale of military officers. Now, what do you think federal government can do? How can they get it right? Because insecurity is really diminishing the progress of this country, and of course, democracy.
Yeah, thank you very much. Like I said before, the issue of insecurity is not a recent phenomenon.
Yes.
Insecurity has been there. When you are afraid of your neighbor, when there is a state of faithlessness, when there is doubt, when there is you lack confidence within your environment, yourself and your environment, you are insecure. One of the cardinal responsibilities of government is to make sure that the nation is secure. That is the primary goal of government. And I believe the government, they are trying their best, and they need to step up the ante. The Nigerian military, they are doing exceedingly well. I recently learned that they were able to conquer again some of the commanders of the Boko Haram. Over 50 of them made their water low. The bushes have been combed. In fact, I must give it to our military. They are trying. They are the front line, working to defend the territorial integrity of our nation. They are trying. Even the Nigerian police, they are also doing their best. But the issue is this. They have not been well equipped. They have not been well equipped. They need to be well equipped so that they can face the challenges of this insecurity squarely. We know we have different type of insecurity, but the major insecurity that is ravaging this nation is insurgency, banditry. That is what is happening. It's trying to tear the country apart, and it's affecting the ethnic nationality in Nigeria. My own take about this is this: all this euphoria of insecurity, I believe one day it will be over. But the most important thing is that the ethnic group in Nigeria, we're over 370 ethnic nationalities. We should be able to unite ourselves. Those who are fighting Nigeria, they are not Nigerians. They are not Nigerians. Our border is porous. They are not Nigerians. The real Nigerians, they will not fight each other the way we are seeing it like now in Nigeria right now. We will not fight each other. There is conflicts. There must be a resolution. There have not been any country where there are wars, where such wars have not been settled on the table. But right now, as I speak to you, I want to use opportunity to speak to the federal government that we believe in Nigeria nation. Nigeria of our dream will appear when we love each other. It's only true love that can heal this nation. As an ambassador of peace, we preach forgiveness. We preach unity, cooperation, and co-prosperity. Let us see how best we can come together. And I said, the killing is too much. The infighting is too much. Nepotism, tribalism is too much. This is now our nation, Nigeria. Let us come together and build a nation where God can bless all our hard work. Like our national anthem. We have the national prayers. So we need to employ it. It's as if we are forgetting it. Nigeria is a blessed nation. And I believe that with all our energies, with all our prayers, God will heal this nation. The prayer of the poor, the prayer of the poor and the needy in this country who have been badly hit by this insecurity, God have heard such prayers. And I believe this issue of insecurity one day will be a thing of the past.
Okay. Thank you.
At the same time,
yes,
I will continue to thank the Nigerian military. Lord, we have lost a lot of personnel.
Yeah.
Even Nigerian police, we have lost a lot of personnel. If they are not determined to work for peace, for work for security of this nation, they will not put their life on the line. I must give it to them. They are trying. We are here sitting in our comfort zone, but they are facing the music at the trench. So like our brother here, when we were Uniben, he was a provost master, a provost marshal of the Man of War Club, University of Benin. Very tough officer. You dare not go where they say stop, you will stop. At all, very tough. So it's like the military of today. So
yes.
I like the name because of his action.
Yes.
What we are seeing, the insecurity in Nigeria will be a thing of the past.
Thank you very much. Okay, well, I just got information. You know, the role of IPOB, that IPOB played a pivotal role to making security possible during the Anambra election. You know, there was a seat at home order from IPOB, but later IPOB withdrew that seat at home order. And we also got information that their role actually played a very, very important security success in that Anambra election. Okay, Apostle Casey, now, as a way forward, what do you think should be done to enhance security in this country?
Okay, before I answer that question, let me contribute to Mr. Osasu.
Okay.
He said the people fighting Nigerians are not Nigerians. Our governors are Nigerians, our president are Nigerians, and all they are the ones fighting us.
No, they are not
because
the ones fighting
Nigeria.
They were elected to rule us.
They cannot give us security. Then who do we blame? If they cannot give us security, me and you are aware that in police station there is no vehicle. When you call an hotel, there is no vehicle to move for operation. What are the federal government doing? What are the state government doing? So they are the one bringing problem to us. Now I want to say this: the way forward lies on 2023 election. If our leaders, those one who has been there, can humble themselves and say we are not doing again, let the young ones take over, all this insecurity will stop. Because the reason why some of them are leaving this Boko Haram so that they will see people will help them steal ballot box in 2023 election. So that they will see people will help them cause disaster in a polling unit in 2023 election. So if they can humble themselves and say, we have overeat this country, let us step backward. Let the young men come forward and put this country in order. We will have a better Nigeria. It does not take them anything to wipe Boko Haram. It does not take them anything to wipe banditry. But they left those people in the bush because they know that they are going to need them in 2023 election. So the only way forward is for the old people who have been in power. We are tired of them. They have eaten this country enough. Before I was born, they have been a leader. I'm still alive and I'm getting old. They are still sitting in that seat. There must be a problem. Let them step down and let young men take over. That is the only way we know that we have started getting security right. Because right now, they know that nobody loves them, nobody wants to accept them. So if they see you are against them, they will threaten you a little bit with insecurity. They will come and keep people in order. Before you know, you want to support. So, okay, instead of us to just die, let's just support one.
Okay, Abu, so Kesi, I'm going to interject, but when I come back, you will continue. Because some persons believe that the youths, you are fighting for the youths now. The youths are supposed to be in charge because of number. But are they taking advantage of their number? You answer that after. Yes, nice to have you back on the program, 60 Minutes Nigeria. Before the break, my guest, a clergyman, Apostle Kesi Chukwu, emphasized the importance of youths occupying public offices. Well, he's going to tell us. The youths, are they expecting butter and bread? Are they expecting that the positions will be given to them, or they have to campaign, they have to put in effort, they have to stand for elections, they have the number? Are there, is there cooperation among the youths to vote for the youths?
Well, the youths have the number, but they don't have the right source to get into power. Number one, you can see that our government is making sure that the youth don't get job. So how do you expect a man who barely pays house rent, who barely feed, to come and contest for an election? When me and you know that that election is blood that will come out. When I talk about blood, I'm talking about money. It will come out from me. So they are doing everything to render the youth useless. By the time the youth cannot afford 1,000 naira in a week, then when the youth see 2,000 naira in a polling unit, he will change his mind and vote for anybody he want to vote for. So they are.
But is that right? Is that right?
It's not right. That is why the leader should humble themselves and come and say, now we want to fix this country. Youth, come into power. Without mago-mago, without any doing the way they are manipulating things. Mm. Let youth come into power and rule this country. There are youth that can rule this country. Me and you know. But the government are doing everything to cripple the youth. Financially, there's no job, there's nothing at all.
I still disagree with you again. The government is not crippling the youths. The government has assured that they are fixing the economy. Not everybody can be employed by government.
Mr. Wessens, do you know
youths can be self-employed?
Do you know how many self-employed? Where did he get the money from? Where is he going to get the money from? Self-employed. Do you know how many youth have graduated from the university? Thousands of youth, no job today. Some have been there, some people have graduated for the past 10 years, 15 years, 7 years, no job. And you say the youth you empower yourself, you should go and steal.
No,
that's or you should
I'm
go
saying.
And carry God to.
No, before you call me, what I'm saying is that, yes, we know that the youth have the capacity to rule this country. We know that. But the point we are making is, the youth have the number. If all the youth agree, it's okay. We are going to vote for Apostle Kesi Chukwu, for example, all the youths. They will win because they have the number. That's the point I'm making. But yes, Apostle Kesi Chukwu is talking about the influence of money in Nigerian political scene. We are not ruling that out. But
I didn't agree with him that government is deliberately making the youth unemployed. No, they have told us they are making efforts to get people employed. Yes, they may not be able to employ everybody at the same time, but it's a gradual thing, and that's the point I'm making.
Who will give the youth money to buy for?
Okay, so let's
quickly come in. I've been a youth leader.
Yes.
I've been secretary, National Youth Council of Nigeria, Edo State.
Okay.
And for some time, I've been able to work with the youth of the states.
Yes.
And even in the nation, at the point,
yes.
I was a national president of National Youth Council of Nigeria secretary.
Okay.
In the country.
Okay.
And I also floated a campaign.
Okay.
During my time,
yes,
as national president. What we are seeing right now, government cannot provide job for all the youths.
Okay.
We need to also create job by ourselves. We need to be self-sufficient. And at the same time, youths occupy over 75% of population that can deliver anybody for any offices.
Yes.
In any offices.
Yes.
At this point, it is clear to note that Nigeria democracy or Nigeria politics is capital intensive. Without money, you cannot venture into it.
Mm.
It is the money bag that canvasses a youth who is struggling. Maybe he's a shoemaker.
Okay.
A youth who is struggling as a petty trader. A youth who is struggling as a farmer. You ask him to leave his home, you start campaigning, going out. You need money to persuade him so that he can leave what he's doing for 1 hour or 2 hours. So in Nigeria, politics is too capital intensive. So that is why the youth cannot stand to say, okay, they want to, vote a fellow youth to win, because they need money to persuade them. Because psychologically, the youth have been reduced in this country to determine issues for themselves. Because finances or finance is very key for you to win any election. Because as you move along the streets, you must buy pure water. As you move along the streets, you must buy food. As you move along the street, you must pay their transport. Where would the youth get such money? Except they key into somebody who they believe to be a leader, who can be able to provide those necessary
funds
for them to strive. The youth strive better when you support them. The youth strive better when you encourage them. The youth strive better when you inspire them. And the youth are the hope of this nation. That is why the kind of education we give to youth today matters a lot tomorrow. Because if we must have a decent future tomorrow, we must have it now. The government must come up with a policy to reduce the high level of expenditure in politics, so that the youth can also, by themselves, also key into it. Because one day they will be elected as governor, they will be elected as president, they will be elected as local government chairman. Without this internal preparation, we will miss it. Because right now dollar is 570 naira.
Is it not coming down?
Is it coming down? I wouldn't know. So now how can you muzzle such money for politics? Where will you get it from? Will you get such
which
money?
Job will they employ
which
you?
Which job? How will you get this money? Because right now, too much money chases few goals. At this point, the youth are struggling to survive. They are struggling to pay their school fees, their house rent, and so on. All their basic needs. You wanted to indulge in politics? So government must reduce the burden. So everybody can participate, because it's democracy. It's always of the people, by the people, and for the people. If it's by the people, for the people, therefore, government must reduce it, allow a free hand for people to participate, so that the youth can present a fellow youth to become governor. Like what you said, you give it to the governor, that the governor is encouraging youth in government. And that is what we want. We want youth to be in government. We want youth to participate, so that they can prepare themselves and face the challenges of tomorrow. They are role model. I like what Godwin is doing for preparing youth for the future. And that is what we want. Let the youth step up so that they can become hope for the hopeless for tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Yes, Atoy, I can see that you are itching to make a point.
Yes.
Yes.
The topic, security challenges, are
yeah.
Do you know we should
democracy or security is local. We should leave the national. The president, I'll always give it to him. You call him a Fulani man, I call him my president. There are so many programs he has introduced for the youth. Very close to my office, there is this Empower. You will not hear it anywhere. People, youth have been prepared as extension workers to teach people how to farm. They pay their money. But you see some of our politicians, because they are there, they will put their cousin, their whatever, they put their name. Those who need that extension services,
not give them.
Those who need that job, mm-hmm. they will not give them. How can you bring somebody who is physically challenged to be an extension worker? For the person to climb upstairs to take training is a problem. But that is not the issue. But Anna has, how did she happen to be this list is an issue. That is the security challenges we have. Let us take it to Edo State. The last summit allowed out, as the Benin man will say, allowed out moving forward. I will tell you, I wish I was not there, I would have been arguing like I discover why the governor has so many people trying to fight him in the party. I'm not coming here to discuss party matter, but you see, when you are trying to turn the old way of doing things to the new way or the better way you think things can be done to get more results, you will see the element that benefit from the old way. They will rise up to fight you. And I've also discovered that those who grab land, those who oppress the poor, those who intimidate the poor, those who are anti-democracy, they are very generous. They will kill 10 people and give one man cow. They will televise it. They will take 100, they will take a full community and build a 5-bedroom for one widow. They will televise it. People will say this person is a philanthropist. It's a lie. Those are the things we are trying to bring out.
Mm.
Why is this man building a police station for police?
Mm.
What is he doing? Where is he working? And I will beg the media. Security starts from the media. People should not come to the television or to the media houses to showcase who they are. I don't want to go to the religious side. They will come. They will say they are giving this money to the poor. You are taking their tithe. Teach them what is tithing. That is where the issue is. But I'm not going there. Let us go into what we are doing in the local and the state. I will tell you this. The government of this day of Edo State should come more and tell the people what the government is doing. I'm in the agricultural sector. Our crops is so defined. And the governor saw it. What will I go? Where will I go? He dived into it and is investing. My prayer for them is that the governor, he said it, 4 years I was going around. But my second term now, this first year I just had, I now have a direction. He said they are asking him, who will succeed you? The governor should not be afraid who will succeed him. The person that will succeed him will come, because his style of leadership is what democracy defines, not Governor Obaseki defines. He's doing democracy the way it should be. Let the people lead. Do you know those he employed did not come through the back door? They applied, they did test, they went for interview, and they were employed. If anybody said I use money to get employment, is a liar.
Yeah.
Because somebody in my office benefited. He just tried it and they called him. Today he has been employed. Now, if he's doing that, why are people not saying it? That is how we should go. You don't need a senator to recommend you.
Mm-hmm.
You don't need a House of Assembly member to recommend you. And these are the areas the youth can be in. Let me tell you, Edo have tried it, Anambra did it. It will go around Ekiti, we are waiting for Ekiti next year. It will go around Lagos now. Money bag will not decide.
That is why in our party they have three congress there. Do you know why? In Edo State, we did our congress. I said we are not going to talk here because the Benin said use one word. They said I agree. When we deceive ourselves, there will not be quarrel. But when we tell ourselves the truth, you will see. Do you know why? In Edo State now, everybody is calm. Do you know why? Because the governor is not doing what he used to do. Share the what? The money.
Money.
People say, is it not? It's a governor. The money is sitting on as a governor. It's enough for him. He has been doing business before. The former governor that handed over to him told us he is the brain behind his success. And the way the former governor was living, he uses a helicopter. Since he left office, has he ever used a helicopter to his village? Those are the things we call waste in governance. When you see comfort of commissioner during his days, you will see a commissioner traveling with helos or whatever. Now, a commissioner now sometimes he uses his leg. Whereas when you go to abroad, a commissioner does not use siren, a governor does not use siren. So when you see a government trying to block loopholes, I'm coming just now, I saw a female with a badge number selling ticket in Edo State. You see them holding sticks, matured men, they'll say it's a contract, they will collect money, they were richer than the government.
Mm.
People are not saying we've achieved in that area. The youth are not being engaged directly or indirectly. What I will tell the youth is this: shine your heart. Don't wait for somebody to give you money. Whatever you are doing, just hold it. 2023, whoever is thinking that will bring money, money will not decide anything. A person like me, I'm leaving the youth, because whenever I see those the government is employing, we are getting close to our very close to my 50 now, and there is no way I can be employed now. That is why I'm already self-employed. But we'll put our feet right on the ground and make sure that the generation below, under us, see the light. Because this time around now, whenever I go to the governor's function, the state government function, after the first standard, they will sing the second standard as prayers. Because in the second standard, they said, tell the youth the truth to know. And if you tell the youth the truth and they know, my brother, no matter the money you bring, you cannot convince them.
Yeah.
And if Edo State is not using it as a prayer, not calling one clergy, I was so impressed. When the governor comes, they'll sing the national anthem, they'll say the second standard for prayers. And you will know that this country is blessed. Now people abroad, whenever they see that clip, we have two national anthems, one for the nation, one for the prayers. And everything about that second standard is about the youth. And who are the youth? Some old men of 60, their brain is as good as the one of the youth.
Yeah.
If we are using number defining a youth, we'll get it wrong. Because they will tell you, the Yahoo Yahoo boys, who are they? But I tell you, I saw somebody about 60-something still doing Yahoo. So it's not about youth. It's not about criminality.
Yes.
You understand? So they should not target that young boys are Yahoo. No. Old men still do it. So, but if we can support ourselves and say, look, 2023 is coming. It's not by the jingle. Let us see what the governor is doing. The governor is going to agriculture. How many people? He's not going to study it. He has revived a technical school very close to my place in Limit. The school of nursing that was killed is reviving it. You will not hear anybody saying it.
Igodaki
is getting there. Let me tell you, a room was not built in a day. As long as he's bringing the youth out, before they were saying he's bringing people from Lagos to come and work here. I will tell you, in my farm, when you employ people from this state, they will take money, they will not work. I need to travel to three states.
I wouldn't want to support that.
No. I'm telling you now. I'm a farmer. In the farm, I know there are no amenities in the farm. Now, that is why we are begging the government. please support us. We are there already. Support us so that we can, it can attract the youth. What are the youth really looking for? Good road electricity. This
basic infrastructure. Basic amenities.
Amenities where you can go and
watch a
Premier League and all that. This is a view center.
Okay, satellite.
Yes. If there is light, you have a view center. You see the youth. Go to the village where I farm. All the youth there, they are on dread. When you see them in Benin, you think they are Yahoo boys. It's a lie. They are farmers. But those amenities are not in the village
to sustain them.
Every weekend they come to Benin.
Yeah.
And when the government support us and bring those amenities there, forget it. We cannot change the society. The society is about the good, the bad, and the ugly. But the government, as you are doing it, let the road, do the road for us. Partner with those who are farmers. Because I went to Alawudao, because as a Benin man, Alawudao is moving forward. I want to move my farm forward.
Yes.
I want to move everything forward.
Yes.
The only one who can move forward, don't give us money. Create the ability. Let us partner, because the governor said it. I heard it. He said there is money. Money to turn the state around. But how will you get it? People will come with wicked and white elephant project. It's not real. But the governor is very calculative. He said, this is my government. And he's not waiting for AFCC to come and knock when he finish. I believe if he tread well, it will be one of the governors who will be truly called SLSC. Not this one they are calling SLSC, who AFCC is chasing up and down.
At first I thought...
Because that is the challenge.
Yeah, at first I thought, thank you. Yeah. Your closing remark, Apostle Casey, closing remark.
Okay, my closing remark is this security issue, let it start from Nigeria police. You can see that there are some people who has been in Nigeria police for the past 10 years, they are still trekking. Why some young one who just came, they are driving BB cars. Nobody is asking those young policemen, how did they get those cars they are driving? And our politicians, those one who are councillor for just 1 year, they are already building mansions. They are already driving big cars. These people should, if while they are on seat, they should be investigated. Nigerian police, those who are driving BB cars, how much is their salary? They should be investigated just the way they are investigating all these Yahoo boys. That is my closing remark.
Thank you. Ambassador Osasu.
Yeah, thank you very much. First of all, I must thank the Nigerian Army for their gallantry. I must also thank the Nigerian police.
I don't know why you are thanking these people.
Because without them, I must tell you, without
them, they not do their job.
No, society would have been a mess.
Yes, sir.
If you look at the CP, the Commissioner of Police of Edo State, Philip Badu, my goodness, he's a phenomenon. We like you. This man is wonderful. If you look at the trend of insecurity in Edo State, it has reduced to barest minimum.
Is it not because of the governor's effort of bringing up vigilante?
I'm coming towards that.
Yeah.
I must also thank the governor for being able to set up this independent security apparatus.
Yes.
Headed by...
Vigilante Network.
Headed by Aruna, CSP retired.
Yes.
Wonderful job. I also thank DC Miller, the director of operation, Nigerian Police Edo State, very good. And also Francis Dauda Asia, who is also operating an independent security vigilante. They are working very well. And at the same time, I also want to speak to our parents. Speak to our families, because insecurity starts from the home. We must be able to deal with our home. The basic tradition of education, the primary education, must start from the home. It goes to the society and to the nation and to the world. We must be able to instill a very good moral values on our children. That is what we are lacking. According to Africa cosmology, or Africa see the world, we see it as a family. Today, we are no longer families, because it takes a community to build a child.
Thank you, Ambassador.
Thank you very
closing
much.
Remark, Fosa Atoy.
My closing remark, I will say this. This song, I say, ego or defi.
What's the meaning of that?
He said,
money sustain
wealth. Money sustain wealth. Democracy. For we to move forward.
In the farm.
in the farm.
In democracy.
In democracy.
Yes.
My brother is money. And the only way we can just make the money flourish is for we to bring back the attitude of commitment and engagement.
That is it.
So that is my...
Thank you very much. Well, my viewer out there, I hope you've enjoyed this week's edition of the program, 60 Minutes Nigeria, Current Affairs program, where every week we dissect national issues. And we'll be looking at security challenges and, of course, its effect on democracy. And we brought out what happened in Anambra as a case study while we postulate ahead of other elections in the country. My name is Egosa Agbonlao. Do have a wonderful week ahead. Bye-bye.